Greetings, fellow conspirators. Martyrsvale here, and today we are on the BKC Attack of the B Team server. Mwahaha. That's right. The BKC server is now running the Attack of the B Team mod pack, which, if you don't know, is a crazy mod pack from Technic and the B Team, which includes all kinds of new crazy mods that you can do a lot of stuff with. I'm looking forward to it. It looks like so much fun. And actually, one of the common mods between the Attack of the Bee Team mod pack and the Feed the Beast mod pack is Tinker's Construct, and this is a mod that allows you to basically make your own custom tools, which is really, really cool, and I've been dying to get into that, and that's what we're going to do for this first episode. Now, in order to make some really good tools, it's going to take us a lot of materials. Hey, guy. Who are you? Creature name. Kind of creepy. Creepy looking face there. Yeah, so we've got to get some materials going, which is not going to be too hard in this mod pack. I don't think there's very common. See, redstone, diamond. You know what? Actually, I don't have iron yet. I got to get some stuff going, but basically I'm going to take you guys through the Tinker's Construct and build some cool tools this episode, and I'll show you how all that works, and I'll be back once I've got a little base set up and a few resources going. Let me tell you guys, caving is something else in this mod pack. Let me just go ahead and show you here. Look at that. Half a stack of diamonds, so much copper ore, iron, tin, silver, redstone, quantum dust. I'm looking forward to working with that stuff. Yeah, we've got everything that we need, and I just barely raided not even half of a ravine. So, caving should not be a problem. But anyways, guys, I think this is where we're going to settle down, at least for temporary. I really like this stuff. It's crag rock. It makes a sand/dirt sound, but I think the pick is the right tool for it. I don't know, it's really cool. And plus, up there, well, there's a cloud there. Up here, we've got a slime island, which spawns blue slime and stuff. And actually, I think it'd be a good idea to go take a look at that now. Check this out. I killed a bat. So now, I can fly. Whee-hee! this is really cool. This is the best thing ever for getting around. Really like it. So, we'll go take a look up here. Ta-da! Ooh. Take that. We have slimy grass and this slime water, congealed blue slime, congealed green slime. And actually, can I chop this down? I think this will drop a sapling, hopefully, that we can use for something else. So I'm going to go ahead and chop these trees down. Oh, I heard a slime, I think. Ah, there he is. Hey, guy. Yeah, these guys drop blue slime, which I think we can eat. I'm not mistaken. It smells terrible, but if you have nothing else to eat, then I guess that's what we'll have to eat. But, yeah, anyways, slimy leaves. Oh, there it goes. Okay, yeah. There we go. We got 4 saplings out of that. Oops. Controlling the bat is a little bit difficult. But yeah, that's good. So now we've got some of that stuff. Now let's head back down to our base here. And I'll show you guys what we're going to get doing with Tinker's Construct. So we've got this book here, Materials and You by Skyla. Aha! So it shows us some different crafting recipes for these different stations that we're going to need. And so I'll just go ahead and make those. We're going to need 4 stencils. That means we're going to need... we'll just make that many. And we'll put those there. 4 and 4. Alright, or those are patterns, I'm sorry. So now we'll make 1 stencil table, make 1 part builder, make one, I don't remember what this is called, tool station, and then the last one is a chest of some sort, I believe. So we'll just make 1 chest, like so, and there we go. So these are basic Tinker's Construct items. Let's go ahead and set these on the other side. So our stencil table we'll put here, I guess. Pattern chest, that can go on the other side, I think. And then we'll want part builder, I guess, here. And tool station there. I don't really know which way this works. But those are the basics. Now, actually, let me get out of this bat mode because it's a little weird. And also, let me make sure that there's nothing out here that's going to kill us. Nope, we look safe for the most part, I think. Cool. Yeah, I really like this rock. It's like a cyanish turquoise color. But kind of cobblestone-y. I don't know. It looks cool. Looks cool, okay? Leave me alone. Alright. So these are basic stations, and we're going to need to make some stencils in order to make tools. But this is sort of the basic stuff, and this is for things like wooden stone tools, and we've already progressed past that, as you can see by what we're doing. So the next thing is we're going to need to make a smeltery, and that takes... Actually, we'll need to make a tool forge as well, eventually, but that takes seared bricks, which is what these are. And in order to make those, we're going to need this seared brick, which is made from grout, which is made from sand, gravel, and clay. And I don't have very much of any of those, so I'm going to have to go get a lot in order to make the seared brick stuff. Yeah, so I will be right back once I've collected enough grout to make these seared bricks. Grout has been gotten. So just a reminder, guys, all you got to do is take the clay, the gravel, and the sand, put them together, and you got some grout. Then you just got to cook that up in a furnace, and you will have seared brick. That should probably be enough. Now, of course, it's fairly similar to making nether brick or bricks or anything like that. You just put them together in that sort of pattern. Ah, we got a book. Interesting. Because the thing I was getting ready to show you guys was this. That'll give you a second book, Materials and You. And then to do that again, okay. Okay, I see. Oh, we can't get the last one back. Oh well. So we've got our book on Mighty Smelting now. And I think this will teach us how to make the smeltery. So, we're going to need a smeltery controller, a seared tank, 9 seared bricks, and then we're going to need tank strains and a faucet and a casting table. So we're going to put them all together like this, and I'll just go ahead and show you guys how to do that. So, ooh, I shouldn't have used up all my bricks. That's okay, we still have some left over. So here's the smeltery controller. You make a furnace pattern. Glass in the middle will give you the tank. This will make a drain. That'll make seared glass. That'll make a seared window. Faucet, we'll need a few of those. We'll need any of those. We'll need a couple of these, a couple of those. Okay. So while the rest of that's cooking. Okay, so we still have some seared bricks left over. Whew! I must have made a mistake there. Let's actually get some glass cooking. Do we have any left over? We might not have enough. 9. Eh, that might cut it. Maybe. Let's go ahead and get all of that smelting. So for the bottom, we're going to want a 3x3 like that. And we're going to want some on the sides, and these should actually be replaced in the end. But for right now, we're just getting the basis nailed down. And I'll switch these out later. I just want to show you guys how it'll work. And this is going to be the simplest size of smeltery that we can build. We can obviously make this taller in order to fit more liquids inside, but this is the basic size. So now we're going to want that smeltery controller. So let's go ahead and like so. Smeltery controller. We're actually going to want 2 of those, so I'll go ahead and wait. Do we have any extra? There we go. So we're going to want 1, 2 of these. And was this something? Yeah, that's a drain. Okay, we're going to want, I think, 4 of those. We might be cutting it pretty close, guys. It's okay, I can always go out and get more grout. So these 2 will be here, which means we can knock out that. And that. And then we'll have 2 more on the other side. possibly only one, depending on how much we have left. And here, I guess we'll put the smelter controller, like so. We're also going to need a place to put in the lava. Actually, let's, to keep things even, go ahead and take those out. And we'll put the controller there, put a brick in here, and what was the tank's recipe again? Look through here. Green tank. Okay, that's with the one glass in the middle. Okay. So, here, put that glass. Oh, it's in here. No, that's in there. Glass is in there, okay. So glass was just one glass in the middle and brick all around, I believe. Yes, so there's our tank. Alright, so we'll leave that there. Aha, and there we go. So now we're almost done. We can go ahead and fill this with lava, I think, by right-clicking, but I want to finish this off first before we do that. So we'll need to make four more drains and some basins. I don't know if we're going to have enough bricks for that. Yeah, I think we've ran out, guys. So we have 8 left. Let's go ahead and make one more drain, and I can finish off this part of it. Like so. Okie doke. Oh, we also need faucets. Well, tell you what, guys, I'll be right back. Didn't realize that's not right. Didn't realize how much I was going to need. So we'll be right back. Grout part 2 has been acquired. And now we're going to need 4 of these, like so. We're going to need 2 more of these, like that, and we're going to need a little bit more for that. Perfect. And there we go. And so this is for a slightly improved version. You technically don't need all this stuff, but in order to maximize my workflow, I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. Okay, now let's put in these seared faucets, like so. And we'll want the basins on this side, like that. Now I can walk around to the other side, and we want these faucets here. Alright, now this smeltery should be complete. So what we have over here is the controller, and this is all the stuff that we can smelt, and we, in order to smelt it, we're going to need lava. So we'll just put in some lava. There we go. I'll have to probably go get some more, because this is not... Actually, we'll see how much that fills up. Yeah, we're going to need a little bit more, I think. Go ahead and put some more in. We'll use it up anyway. And there we go. This smeltery should be fully functional. Now, what does this do that a furnace does not, you may ask? Well, I'll go ahead and show you. Let's take some metals. Let's take some gold ore and some, I guess iron would probably be good. Yeah, take some golden iron. So now we can only melt these one at a time, like so. So we'll put in a few of those, like that. And I'll put in some iron as well, because molten iron is probably good to have. Okay, so as you can see, this little bar here is showing how much of this is melted. And once that reaches completion, we'll get a little bit of molten gold, or molten iron in here. When we're done with that, then we can make them into blocks of iron using these basins, or we can make what they call patterns out of them. Or stencils? No, not stencils. Patterns? I don't know. So over here we have the pattern chest, and you make these using the stencils, so I'll just go ahead and make one more to show you. Need 2 like that, and 2 sticks like that, and there's, you got a blank pattern. Then you take it over to the stencil table, put it in, and you make a pattern with it. I've already made most of these. Let's just made a scythe, excavator, large blade. Let's make a hammer. I haven't made that one yet. Okay. Then we put that in this chest, and then they're available to us for making different parts. Now, let's say, first we're probably going to want a pickaxe. So let's go ahead and put a pick head in there, put that there, and now we have a wooden pickaxe head. Okay. So now I've got a wooden pickaxe head. We'll need a tool binding. So we'll probably make this out of a different material, but we'll go ahead and make one just to be sure. Alright, so we've got a wooden binding and an extra stick left over. And we'll make a tool rod out of wood as well. There we go. They look similar, but they're not the same. So now, if we wanted to, we could go over here and make a completely wooden pick. So if we select pick, put the wooden tool rod there, the wooden pickaxe head there, and a wooden binding there. And there's our wooden pick. It's not very good, so we're not going to do that. What we made these things for is to put them in here so that we can cast them. So put a wooden tool rod there and our wooden pickaxe head there. Okay, so now when we pour molten gold out, it'll make a cast, I think is what they call it, out of that. And we can use that to make more advanced tools. So if we look in here, we have molten gold at the bottom, molten iron there. What's at the bottom will flow out first. Kind of makes sense intuitively like that. So we'll go ahead and hit the faucet, watch it fill up, and perfect. Once this dries, there we go. So now we have a tool rod cast. Now we can take that out. So the tool rod cast is pretty cool because these stencils that we made over here, they're very flimsy. So like we could make stone and wooden tools out of them, but if we wanted to make a molten iron tool, we couldn't do that. But now that we have this, we can make we could pour molten iron in here and make an iron, completely iron pickaxe. We'll do the same thing with the pickaxe head. There we go. So now we've got casts for each of these, which are going to be big in what we're trying to do here. So now we're actually done with these. I can go ahead and toss them. Bye-bye. So now we've got casts. That's really cool. Now, the next level of stuff up, because I don't want to go ahead and make an iron tool yet. I want to make the best pickaxe in the game. And so that is going to involve, well, I already screwed up the book, but it's going to involve some cobalt and a different alloys. So basically what the smeltery does is, if you melt, let's say, some different metals at the same time, it'll mix them all together and it'll make an alloy out of them. So you can make stronger materials like that. So that's been a quick overview of the smeltery. This thing should be working good. Actually, hang on. One more thing. Let's go ahead and we want iron at the bottom. Now let's make two blocks of iron. We're actually going to need four, because the other thing we want to make is, take that away, we're going to need one more of those, like that, I think. Okay, and let's go see about our blocks of iron. Perfect, thank you very much. I don't know that we actually have enough. Let me see. Yeah, we're running out of iron. Let's go ahead and fill that back up. Some more iron. And once that melts, we'll be able to make one more block of iron. Actually, that's probably too much, but that's okay. Yeah, still waiting on a little bit of iron, so that's okay. I think this should be fine. Like, I'll just leave that as it is. And once this iron melts, it should complete the process. Hopefully. This is actually, we're experimenting right now. I don't know the answer to this. So, I'm kind of curious. This could explode in our faces, guys. What's that? That's weird. Is this? Okay, that's the iron melting, I think? Yeah, that makes sense, okay. So once this melts completely, we should see this go away and have the molten stuff in there. I hope. I don't want to click on it in case I mess anything up. Okay, there we go. It's almost totally melted. Actually, take these out while we're over here. First skeleton. Aha! Miss me. Gotcha, sucker. Okay. Sorry about that, guys. Got a little distracted by it being attacked. Ooh, I should go over there and get that slime, but I won't. Okay, iron is almost melted. Here we go, the moment of truth. Have we fouled up? Have we mucked this experiment up? Let's hope not. This cloud. Go away, cloud. Fingers crossed. Oh. Oh. I don't want to fall in there, because it does actually damage you if you fall into molten iron, which kind of makes sense. Because that seems like something that would happen in real life. Yeah, you can tell these aren't real blocks, because... Oh, okay, there we go. Woohoo! Got it. So now, will this finish? Okay, not automatically. Maybe. Uh-oh. That's not... Oh, okay, got it. We want that at the bottom. Okay, now that should work. Okay. Whew! Alright, we did it, guys. That was not as well done as I would have liked, but we did manage to figure it out. Got tons of iron left. And there we go. Got our four blocks. So if we come over here to a crafting table, we can go ahead and put these like that. That there. And that there. We have a tool forge, and this is basically just an advanced version. It just has more tools that we can make. Whew! Okay, guys. So, now I am off on the hunt for some more... Ooh, don't want to fall in there. But for some more stuff, better materials to make our tools out of, and I will return once I have found them. So, here we are with some of these alloys that we can make. And the first one that we're going to make is alumite, and this is the stuff that can mine cobalt, which is what we're going for next to make this, which is probably the best metal in the game. So alumite is made from 5 aluminum, 2 iron, and 2 obsidian. So I went ahead and I got some obsidian, made a diamond pick to do that, and now what we need to do is put in some more aluminum. Aluminum, okay, so we're going to need... 6 more, I believe. And we'll stick that in here. Does that work? Perfect. And we'll put that back in our metal chest. I'll put that back too. Okay. So we're also going to want a portal, and let's just set it up here for now. We'll obviously move it once we figure out where our permanent base is going to be. But for right now, this should be fine. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Let's go ahead and do this. Why not? Like that. There we go. Portal made. And need a flint and steel. A flint in here. And I'll show you guys. I made this other cast, which is an ingot cast. And basically all you have to do is put it in there and select, we want iron, and that'll make an iron ingot. Just like that. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. So we can go ahead and make our flint and steel, like that. Aha! Flint and steel, and light the portal. Woohoo! Alright. And is this done melting? It is. Okay, so now you can see we've got some molten alumite. And with that, actually let's go ahead and select it. We're going to make... Let's go ahead and make a pickaxe head. And that. Yeah, I guess... let's just make the whole thing out of alumite. We're not going to really use it. So we don't really need to, but... Might as well. So there we go, pickaxe head. And, oh, we're gonna need a little cross pattern too. So let's just, it doesn't really need to be that durable, I suppose. So let's just make one out of like stone or something. So, oops, let's put that in there. And tool binding pattern, make it out of stone. No, we won't. We'll make it out of wood, I guess? Oh, I don't want to do that. We might as well make it out of, like, at least iron. What am I doing here? No. We want that. Okay. We'll go ahead and make one of these. Put it into here. And get out the gold. Pour that in there. take out tool binding, put the cast back in, and we'll make it. How much alumite do we have? We have enough, but let's just go ahead and make it out of iron, just because we're cheap. So there we go. Here's going to be our first Tinker's Construct pick. Go over here to the Tool Forge and select a pickaxe. So here's our pick head, here's our tool rod, and here is our binding. Like that. Aha! Tinkerer. Now, what this does, there are a few different things that you make out of different materials. So, for instance, alumite has reinforced, which is basically higher durability. Some things have higher durability, some things have different aspects that you can get on them. So this is a pretty decent pick. It'll be pretty fast. It's better than diamond. Maybe not speed-wise, but it's better than diamond because we can get cobalt. So, speaking of cobalt, let's go into the nether and I'll try to find some and I'll show you guys when I do. Here it is, guys. And by the way, the nether is still a very dangerous place. Even when you can fly like a bat, it's still scary. Okay, so there's cobalt, and we're gonna need some of that in order to make our next items. We're actually gonna need a lot of it. So I will be in here for quite a while looking for it. Although it'll only be a little while for you guys because I will be right back. Here's the other stuff we need, guys. It's called ardite. And when you combine this with cobalt, that makes the M metal stuff, which is the best metal you can get in the game. So we'll need lots of this too. Ardite and cobalt, blue and yellow ore. That's what we're looking for. Whew! Man, we got out of another, but it was pretty rough, guys. I have 30 levels, and I have 33 cobalt ore, 20 ardite ore, and a bunch of quartz, which will come into play later. So for right now, let's just store that in there. So, one problem that I came across in the nether was that I didn't have enough inventory space. So, no, that's not it. So, I figured that I would do something about that. So, let's go ahead and put that in. And, of course, I don't have any wood. Why would I? Let's try that. Ah, there we go. That should work, but it didn't. Maybe there? Oh, that's right, you need more than one. You need three, I think. There we go. Okay. So we can put that back. Let's go ahead and put that there. And get some gold. I think this will work. Let's put that in there. So we're making a cast of the tough tool rod. So there's our gold ingot. We can go ahead and put that back. And we'll put that back too. Now we're going to need iron. Let's get out our iron. We're going to need two of these. So let's put that in. There's one. As soon as it dries. Perfect. And we'll get that other one rolling. For now, we can get rid of that. Goodbye. Thank you very much. Come again. Okay. Now, we've got that. We need some leather. Let's just take all of that. And we can make a knapsack. And this is really cool. So, if I did this right, which I did, knapsack. Aha. So, I'm going to go into this tab right here, and you'll see that we've got a knapsack there, and now we've got an extra inventory space. So this is basically carrying around a single chest full of stuff. So we could put that in there, these apples, all this stuff, I don't care. So that's really cool. But that's not all we want to do. We also want to get some other stuff rolling. So let's put that in there. Let's see, let's go ahead and melt 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, and 1, 2, 3, 4. So what this will do is, in order to make the The M metal, the best metal, you need two gold, cobalt and two ardite. So what this is going to do is this is going to give us four mana whatever and two extra cobalt left over, because we are going to make some other stuff. So let's get out this pickaxe cast, put that in, and I guess we'll get out this for right now. And get those rolling. How are we doing on lava? We could actually use some more. Whoops, that's not what I wanted. I guess we can melt those down to get the iron back, but that is not what I want. Wait, let's go ahead and actually be a ghast. I killed one of these in the nether, and so now we're a ghast. Whee! This would be kind of weird to see a ghast flying around the overworld. This is where I got the obsidian, and there's some other lava lakes around here that I'm just going to exploit. So let's see, we'll just take 1, 2, 3. There we go. That's flowing back, perfect. And we'll just fly back up here. Yeah. Ghast is so big it barely fits on the screen. Go ahead and get back to me. I'll set up my favorites later once I get everything figured out. That was kind of weird. Let's see, we want the lava. No. We right-click on that to put the lava in. Almost forgot. And... ooh, that's... we've already filled it up. Perfect. So I guess we'll just save that for a rainy day. And how's this doing on melting? Ah, okay. Cobalt is already done. And it's making the okay. Anyways, let's get the cobalt at the bottom and see if that's enough for a pickaxe head. It might not be. Yeah, it doesn't. Oh, nope, it was. Okay, cool. How much do we have left over? Like one? Oh, no, that only took one ingot. Okay, perfect. Well, let's take our pickaxe head and let's actually make another one. And we'll probably make three of these. Maybe four, since we already have four ingots in there, why not? So that's three. Yeah, we'll go ahead and make four. Perfect. We can take that away now. And the other thing, so we should be out of cobalt, so now we just have this stuff. So now we're going to make a bunch of tool rods. And this is like the best tool rod we can get in the game. So I'm gonna need a lot of these basically for all of my different tools. So we'll go ahead and make eight of them, I guess, for right now. There we are, perfect. Four. So this is enough for all of the pickaxe heads, and we'll probably make some swords and other stuff with them. So we'll need them regardless. I'm not just wasting this stuff. It was pretty hard to get. But I think it'll be worth it. Alright, so there we go. And we should be out of that now. Oh no, we still have four left? Wow. Okay, well, let's just go ahead and take that away. We'll use the rest for something else. Oh, actually, you know what we need? Let's make a sword blade. Yeah. Let's make several of those, actually. We'll go in here, make a sword blade. Is that going to be enough? It is. Great. And we will put that down here. And so we're going to make a cast of the sword blade, but we have to make that out of gold. Wait, did it hit gold? Yes, it did. Okay. Alright, so now we've got a sword blade cast. And we can get rid of that. And we want to make some, not gold sword blades, but mana whatever. So we'll make maybe, we'll make a few of them to go along with our tool rods. There's two. Can we make four? Might as well, right? Oh, nope, that's it. That's it. It should be anyway. Yeah, okay. So we're completely out of that. So now we have a little bit of alumite, some iron, and some gold left. Okay. Now, the one other thing we're going to want is... let's see. Let me not jump off the cliff here and die like I've done before. I'm going to want some reeds. And there should hopefully be some... Oof. Give me a little heart attack there. There should hopefully be some down here somewhere. Ah, there, I saw some. It's a little buggy. Let's just pretend that didn't happen. Yeah, we'll just pretend that that's working. Okay, so we need... This will actually probably all break off when we hit it. Oh, we're not connected anymore. Okay, I see. Yeah, because nothing's dropping. Okay, so we're having some server difficulties. I will try to relog and be right back. Okie doke, we are back. Got our reeds together. So now we want... the reeds are plentiful enough. We don't have to worry about it. So now I think it's something like that. There we go. That's a stack of paper. Let's go ahead and make two. And we'll also need some books eventually to get some enchanting going, but just make that for now. So now, let's make one of these. Oh, okay, so we've got some left over. Good. And we will make... let's see. How about, do we want a longsword? I'm not sure whether we want... one of these is going to be our player kill... The rapier will be our player killing blade, and this will be our mob killing blade, so I guess we'll go ahead and make a longsword. So that, I think, is a hand guard. There's a wide guard, hand guard, and I think a crossbar. So we'll go ahead and make... We might actually have enough to make both, so hand guard... Good, and yes, we should. So we'll make a crossbar too. And a crossbar. Perfecto mundo. Crossbar, where are you? I know I made you. There we go. Crossbar, okay. Alright, so those are our three things. Now we can come over here to the tool forge. And let's say we want to make a pickaxe. We'll go ahead and put in our tool rod, our paper binding, and our cobalt pickaxe head. And there we go. And this is our one of the perfect picks. But we are not done yet. Oh, no, no. We can also put in what are called modifiers. So we have four modifiers. Any tool will have three modifiers. But since we made a paper... one of the things is paper, that gives us an extra one, and we can put on, I think, six modifiers in total by adding different extra things. And these modifiers will give us different things, and they're basically like enchantments, but some of them do different stuff. So we can put on lapis for luck, we can put on redstone for efficiency, we can put on something for silk touch, something for auto-smelting, something to auto-repair. So, yeah, so this is not done, but it's basically one of the best picks before we do that, so that's good. And we also, let's go ahead and make a rapier, as they say. So the reason why we use cobalt for the pickaxe head was because cobalt has the highest mining speed, but the M metal has the highest attack damage. So we have that, and we also want a longsword. Perfect. Cool. Okay, so these are some of the best weapons we can get in the game. A longsword does something pretty cool. When we hold right-click, gives us a little jump boost. And so basically, this will make us do a lot more damage while we're sprinting, or while when we charge and do that attack. So this is a really offensive weapon. This, the rapier is sort of like it's a player killing weapon because it ignores armor. So it doesn't do, it's not great on damage, and it doesn't do, you know, and it's not really special in any regard except for it ignores armor. So that is really cool in itself. So if this does 3 to 4 hearts of damage, it'll do 3 to 4 hearts of damage even if the player is wearing diamond armor or you know, some of the best armor in this mod pack. So we put some sharpness on it and some different stuff, and that'll be pretty cool. And also when you hold right click, you jump back, so we can kind of, you know, fight and retreat at the same time, which is pretty cool, I think. And yeah, that's it for these two. There's the broadsword, but that's basically just a regular sword. But there's also bows and battle axes and scythes and all this different stuff. So I'm really looking forward to getting into that. But we're not done with these things yet. So first of all, let's see. What do I want to put on this stuff? Let's see. Let's go ahead and try this. That gives us 8 mossy. And it eats our bucket too, which is not perfect. But I haven't found a dungeon yet, so we might have to go with that. Where's the bat? There we go. Don't fall off the mountain. Don't fall off the mountain. Okay. So we'll need to get a little bit more mossy, and we're going to put auto repair on some of this stuff. Now, it makes the tools look kind of meh, but that's okay. It basically means they'll never run out of durability, which is a good thing for us because we don't want to be repairing them all the time. So let's go up here and make some mossy cobblestone. Put in the water buckets and put in the cobble. We can make 3. Like that. And we'll do 1 more. Oh, it doesn't need our bucket. Never mind. Alright, so we've got our bucket back down here. Okay. So there's our mossy. And what we do to make this into the auto repair is we make a block out of it, and that gives us a ball of moss. And so we're going to definitely put this on the pick. I'll show you how that works. Just put the pick in here, put that there, and that gives us auto repair. And let's go ahead. Let's see. What do we want on the longsword? We want looting. We want, I guess, we want auto repair on this, and we might not put auto repair on our player killing blade, I'm not sure, because I can't imagine we're going to use it too much, but who knows indeed with a BKC server. So we'll go ahead and put auto repair on that, and we'll leave that as it is for now. So now, we'll go ahead and use this. As you can see, if we break something, we went ahead and used a durability off of it, but it'll be auto-repaired, basically. So in a little while, you'll see that green bar tick up, and we'll have a brand new pick once again. So that's pretty cool. I really am going to enjoy that. But I'm going to have to go search for the lapis in order to make some fortune and some looting, so I'm going to go do that. Actually, I have 30 levels. Let me go get some books, and I'll see if I can get Fortune 3 on this pick, because that would speed things up a lot. So I will be right back. Alrighty, guys. We should have everything we need. I'm making one final book now. Voila, like so. Okay, so we have our book. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 obsidian. We have 2 diamonds. That is enough for the enchanting table. Alright. And we have 15 bookshelves. So let's set this up. Let's level this up out a little bit. So this pick is already kind of fast. Like, it's decently fast. I'll leave it at that. We can definitely make it faster, so definitely looking forward to modding it. Okay. We'll put our enchantment table. 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, 6. So that was a mistake. That's okay, we can correct mistakes. Can we not? A little bit of wood will be fine. So we'll get one more of those. Oh, and there we go, that's perfect, really. That way we don't have any leftovers. Alright. With less misclicks, there we go. Put our enchantment table in the middle. And it should be a level 30, so here we go, guys. Level 30 on a pickaxe, hoping for Fortune 3 so we can get the lapis rolling in. Literally the farthest thing from Fortune 3, but that's okay. That is okay. We will keep that in here in case we need it, which we won't. Alright, so I'm going to go hunting for lapis, and I will be back in a while. So, we've already got a little bit of lapis, but not quite enough. And I got 30 levels from all that redstone, so I figured I should probably try another level 30 and hopefully get Fortune 3 this time. Well, okay, that's very similar to what we had. That's better though, but still not quite the fortune I was looking for. But I guess as long as we're here, let me show you how this works, because it doesn't matter whether I put it on now or later. So we're gonna go ahead and put some blocks on like this. Some blocks going, and that should be good. So now we go over here to our tool forge, and we put our pick in. Then what we want to do is put in the lapis and this, because this will just make it a little bit faster, and that'll give us 10 luck. So this is 9 and 10, like that. So 10 luck, 20, 30, 40, and then now it'll only count in 9s because we ran out of just regular lapis and we have lapis blocks. But I think once we get up to 100, it'll give us Fortune 1, or maybe it's 150. Yeah, I think it's 150, you get Fortune 1, 300 you get Fortune 2, and then 450 you get Fortune 3. So we'll see if we get have enough to get up to Fortune 1. Hopefully we do. Yeah, we do. And one more. So there we go. Now we have Fortune 1. And we don't have quite enough to get to Fortune 2. But this will be slightly better. And hopefully increase our output. So there we go. So now we have auto repair and luck. And or auto repair and Fortune 1 on our pick. And we'll get that up to Fortune 2, Fortune 3 eventually. So I'm going to go back out there mining. Oh, you see it just moved, so now it went up from durability 93 to 94. And it has obviously more than 100 uses, but the way Tinker's Construct interacts with the F3 and H, it's basically like a percentage. We have 94% left, even if that's more than 94 uses. So I'm going to go back out there and get to mining some more and get some more stuff for us to put on these new tools. Aha! First spawner on the server, and my guess is it's a spider spawner. Oh wow. Okay, back off. Back off, back off. Come on, come on. Let me in there. There we go, got some light in there, that should... There we go. All cleaned up, all lit up. Perfect. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Okay. So we got, I got some stencils. You know, we can make those. So, ooh, dragon eggs. I'm keeping those. Cool. And I might as well take that. Oh, yeah, lots of dragon eggs. That's cool. I want to get into the... I'm not sure. What mod are these from? Minecraft. I'll have to check what mod those are from, but yeah, hatching my own dragons and riding them, that's pretty cool, guys. I think we can get several different types of dragons. We can get, like, fire, water, ether, and there's one more type, I forget. So it's, like, sky and buried deep underground is for the ether and the other one, but I forget what the last name is. So those are pretty cool, as well as the normal one. So that's actually 6 eggs is enough to get 1 dragon of each type, so that's pretty cool. Did we check this chest yet? We did. Alright, so happy with that. Good find, good find. I'm going to keep on the search for lapis and other exciting materials, and I will be back with them. 2 spawners in a row. So we have the spider spawner right there, and if we come down here, la-di-da, got a zombie spawner. That's pretty cool, huh? Huh? So, let's see what we've got in our loot chest. Another dragon egg, I'll take it. Name tags. I'm actually running out of space. Let's take that. Actually, let's go ahead and do this. Let's put all of that away, that away, that away, that away. Okay, that's enough for now. Take all those, and we'll definitely take that. Cool. Alright. And let's put those away for now. And we'll take the mossy cobble. Sweet. So, I'm making progress. Still getting some more lapis. I'll be back with more, or when I find another spawner or something cool like this. Yeehaw, guys! So, we have got our tool situation figured out. So I have this Fortune 3 pick that I got from a lot of Lapis, and also we put Looting 3 with Lapis again on our Longsword. I also made this bow, which has auto repair on it, so it'll never break, which is really cool. It also has haste, and if I can find my other bow to demonstrate, I might have actually thrown it away. Oh no, there it is. Okay. So, the haste, check this out. See how much faster that is? It's not a lot faster, but it's slightly faster, and I can make it a lot faster. But I just wanted to show you guys that it's not, I'll probably go back to a regular bow, because I can't put power on this. I could only modify the arrows, and that just seems like a really micromanagey thing, but for right now it's pretty cool. And actually I'm going to show you how to put extra modifiers on your stuff. You just take a block of gold and some diamonds. I have so many diamonds. I have enough to, like, I've literally started just leaving them because there's so many. So anyways, you just take a block of gold and a diamond, and that gives you one extra modifier. Unfortunately, you can't do this multiple times. If you try it again, look, no extra modifier. Sad day. But that does give you a little bit more, so if I wanted to put some more redstone on it, which I do, and I can just go like this, and that'll give me a little bit faster bow. So as you can see now, it says the draw speed is 0.85 instead of being like 1.2. So that's pretty cool. Let me put that away. So we have a decent bow. I won't say it's good, but it's decent. And now what's the other thing that I wanted to do? Oh yeah. I'm going to make a paper large plate out of stacks of paper, which you just make from putting four paper in like a stone brick formation. And I also want one of these. Alright, there we go. That took a lot of paper, but hopefully it'll be worth it. Now what we want is that, and that. Okay. So first thing we're going to make is a scythe. And I used the cobalt head and two tough rods made out of and I put a paper tough binding on it because to give us an extra modifier. So that'll give us a scythe. And this is a tool you use for leaves, but I think it is also a kind of a decent weapon because I think it's supposed to hit multiple enemies. Let's check the description here. Yeah, it attacks enemies in a wide range, so that could be pretty cool. But even if it's not, we'll just use it for leaves. Also, I forgot to mention this. This is a mattock, and it's basically it's a shovel and a axe and a hoe all in one, and that's really cool. So I don't have to carry an axe and a shovel in my inventory. I can just carry this, and it'll work on dirt and wood. So that's pretty cool. And actually, I think the way this works is the mattock is sort of like a generalized version of these tools, but then you also get specialized versions. So like this lumber axe cuts down a 3x3x3 of wood, or this excavator cuts a 3x3 of dirt. And then the hammer does the same thing with stone. So it's sort of like a trade-off. I'm not getting as good of a tool, but it's a generalized tool, so I can use it on a lot of things. So I think that's probably the best for right now anyway. If I get into like a big digging project, I'll make one of these, or you know, tree farming, I'll get one of these. But for right now, I think this is pretty cool. Anyways, the other thing that we are going to make is a cleaver. And I decided to go with a paper large plate. This actually, I could have made a paper blade, and it would have been the same thing. I just thought that this looked slightly cooler. And I think once we put quartz, well, actually no, we're not going to put quartz on it. So here we go, here's our cleaver. It's got a base attack of 5.5, four modifiers on it. And what this does, it attacks really slowly, you see. But it can behead enemies. So what I want to do is put some moss on it. So it'll auto-repair. I want to put an extra modifier on it before I forget. Although I could do this at any time. And I also want to put what is called beheading on it. So, put in our cleaver, put in some obsidian and enderpearl. And this will give us beheading. So I'll do that once, twice, three times, and I could get beheading 4, or beheading 5, rather, but I don't have enough modifiers on it. So we have beheading 4, and once I get another star, we can get beheading 5. But basically what this does is it allows us to slice the heads off of enemies. And actually, let's see if we can find an enemy around here. Let's actually go into wasp mode. Hello down there. Any enemies? I just want to test this out and see how good the beheading is at beheading 4 and see if we really need to go into beheading 5 or not. Chicken? I don't think I can get a chicken head. What I really want to... I could probably get a pig head. But I really wanted a skeleton or a zombie or something I know I can get there. Skull. Look, is that more diamonds? No, that's 10. There's diamonds. And you know what? I don't even care. I don't even care. Too many diamonds. Sheep. I can get a sheep head, I think. So we did not get a sheep head there. But that actually killed pretty quick. Let's try again. Ooh, that's a necromancy part? Necromancy? They call necromancer, that's how it's pronounced, so I think it's necromancy. So, but there you go, you see it just, repaired itself. So basically what I made this tool for was in order to get wither skeleton skulls, and that'll make it a lot easier, so that I can get nether stars, and nether stars will let you put another modifier on your tools. So, that's pretty cool. I like this. I like that. Hopefully I can also get some player skulls, because that'd be fun. But yeah, so there we go. That's what we've got going so far. Right now, actually. So let me put this away. Yeah, that's part of necromancy. So these things are all part of that. I do want to get into that eventually. But let me... I'm trying to be somewhat organized. Hi, YouTube. Yeah, this guy's cool. Alright, so there we go. Let me also go ahead and put auto-repair on our scythe. And there we go. We've got some pretty good tools now, guys. We'll put those away for now. I'm keeping all of my tools in here, so that way, like, I have my longsword out, but let's say I wanted my rapier, I could just go in here and switch it out pretty easily. So, that's how that works. Yeah. So, I think next, let me see. I haven't found a fortress yet, which is what's really holding me back from finishing these tools, but I guess let's go ahead and make some of this, and I just want to keep in mind I need one slot left over. So, we need quartz, and this will give us sharpness. So we have two modifiers remaining. Have I already put an extra modifier on this? I have not. Okay, cool. So what we're going to do is we're just going to make this sharper. And I think that really improves the look of the blade, but... this will give us a really good player-killing blade, I think, because the rapier ignores enemy armor, like I've said before, so even if we've got somebody walking around in diamond armor, which, you know, everybody's walking around in diamond armor because of how plentiful they are, but even if they are, this will ignore that, so that's pretty cool. And I want to save one modifier, so let's get it up a few more times. And that should be about good. So we'll get two more. Alright, perfect. Don't want to go any higher because we still have one modifier on it. So, this... oh, whoa, we have two modifiers. Okay, that's okay. The other thing that I want to put on this is called Life Steal. And what that does is it gives you a chance of basically... healing yourself for up to a heart of damage whenever you hit an enemy. So let's go ahead and try it. Wait, is this a skeleton? That's a skeleton. Let's try our beheader. See if we can get a skeleton skull out of this. We did not. Oh well. Can I get that stuff? Thank you. I want to try this out because I think this will be pretty close to a one shot. Yeah. That was, okay, so that was a 2. Come on. So, this is already a pretty good blade. I'll put another level of sharpness on it and some life-stealing, and that'll be a really good player-killing blade. Then I'll do the same thing for this, for the longsword. This is going to be our main mob-killing weapon. It's already has looting 3 on it, but I want it to have some sharpness and some life-steal, just in case, you know. So, yeah, that's what we've got going on so far. I'm pretty happy with that, and I'm going to keep on searching for another fortress so we can make the ultimate tools. I found another fortress, guys. Now, I'm not sure what's the best weapon to use against these wither skeletons. The cleaver, it's quite possible that I could behead them. That is at my base. There's one right there. Let's try to behead him first. Okay, that worked. Except now I'm turning into a wither skeleton. That was non-ideal. Wait, am I wearing the armor? Oh, that's pretty cool. I like being a wither skeleton. But no, gotta go back to that. I also need some blaze rods. Don't want to be rude. I also need some blaze rods though, so. Ooh, it's different when I can fly like you, isn't it? Hey. There we go. Can I fly as a blaze? Ooh, I can. That might be worth. Well, no, see, because blazes are still probably 2 blocks high. And I want to be 1 block high, because that is, like, one of the most useful things about being a bat. Let's throw away that. Because I'm also going to need some of this. Or got nothing to do. Yep. That's how it goes. Still got food, okay. Alright, let's keep going, guys. Let's keep trying to get these wither skeletons. Actually, do I have a flint and steel? I do, okay. Always want to keep a flint and steel on you in the nether. In case a gas blows out your portal. In which case, you could be pretty well toasty if you didn't have a flint and steel to relight it. So, that's why I always keep one on me. I'm still looking for... Well, I'll take a blaze. Back up! Oh, that's right. I'm a blaze like you. I think blazes probably have immunity to fire. Let me, Let's actually check that out. And if we look in this thing... Yeah, it shows you the abilities. They're scrolling on the side. So we have flight, immunity to fire... Oh, we get hurt by water, and I'm not sure what that last one is. That's pretty cool. So actually, being a blaze is actually a really good thing in the nether, I would say. So we should probably just try this. Hello? Anybody down there? Any wither skeletons? Does not appear so. Okay. So anyways, guys, I'm going to keep checking this out. I will let you know if I find anything cool, and hopefully we will be able to fight a wither at the end of this episode. Hiya! I am going to call that a successful run, guys. Check this out. 9 wither skeleton skulls in, like, no time. I think that this guy right here worked, I'll say 75-80% of the time. There were only a few times where I didn't get a skull. It was amazing. But we also got these necrotic bones, which are going to let us put soul steel on our items. So I'm have 1 modifier left on this one, and so I'm going to put soul steel on it. Life steel, excuse me. And I'm also going to put it on our rapier. So that's going to eat up the modifiers for both of them. However, we can also get an extra modifier by putting a nether star on each of these items. And since we just so happen to have some wither skeleton skulls, let's go ahead and fight some withers. I honestly think, like, we've got pretty good armor. I'm not going to bring any pictures. This could be a very bad move on my part, but I think I'm going to risk it. So I think if we can fly around like a bat, we'll probably be fine. Because the big hard part about fighting the Wither is shooting him, because he's very hard to hit and he just like flies in your face. But once you get to the melee part, then it's pretty easy. I think most people will agree. So as a bat, I think I can probably just fly in his face and whack him a couple times, and hopefully that'll be good enough. So I just want to find a nice desolate area to fight him in. I was thinking maybe underground might be good, but I don't know. I think that we're pretty powerful at this point already, even with just these tools that we've made, and only one mod has made us pretty powerful. So let's fight him here. Why not? And if this goes well, we might fight too. All right, so got our four soul sand. Perfect. Put those away. And one, two, three. Here we go, guys. This could go very badly for us. And okay. Whoa. Okay, it took off after some. Oh gosh. He's very fast. I don't think I can keep up with him. Okay, there we go. We hit him. So he should be on us, right? Oh, there he is. Oh yeah, look at the damage we're doing already. Chase you up into the sky, bro. You haven't even hit us yet. Come on, man. What you doing? You ain't got nothing on me. Oh yeah. Come on, come on. Fight me. Fight me. Oh, one more hit. One more hit. Come on. There we go. We get it? Yes, we got it. Man, I don't think we barely took any damage there. That was great. Let's go ahead and fight him again. Why not? So let's get out our soul sand. Actually, let me turn down the volume real quick just to make sure that it's not too terribly loud. All right. Actually, well, let's not fight two at once because we might lose the stars. But there's our second one. How's our durability? Durability's perfect. And here we go. Take two. Ha-ha! Now he goes after the chicken immediately. Until we whack him in the face. Hey, guy. Hey, guy. Oh, man, we're doing a lot better than the first time. Oh, already. Already. You are already in melee mode. Weak. Weak. And there we go. Got him. Ah! Come back. Come back. Okay, there's two. One more, guys. Let's try this one more time. Again with the cross. And three heads. Here we go. Man, this is so easy. Being able to fly is the best thing ever. Maybe we should do this in F5. Come at me, bro. Come at me. Oh, you don't like that, do you? That's right. Rah! This little tiny bat battling a wither. Oh yeah, back off, back off. Rah! This is so cool. Oh, no, no. There we go. Got him. Whee! Alright, we didn't get that last star. It fell probably over here with the experience. That could have been a mistake. Let me check. Alright, looking around, looking around. I think items float on top of liquids, so I don't think it's in there. If we lost it, it's actually not a huge deal. It's pretty easy to farm these things. But I would like to find it. This will probably hurt us. Yeah. I don't see it under there. Okay. That's all right. I'm going to look around a little bit more, guys. But if I don't find it, I'll just meet you back at base. Well, sadly, I never did find that other nether star, but we still have two, and that's more than enough for what we want to finish up making these tools. So let's get started. First, we want to make some fire charges. And to do that, we need blaze powder. And how many does this make? It makes three. Okay, we're going to need four. So we'll just have some extra ones like that. All right, so now we have these. We have blaze rods, and we have a bucket of lava. And so if we arrange this like... I think it's like this, but it might be the other way around. Oh no, it's like that. Okay, that gives us a lava crystal. So that's one of the things we want to make. Now, the other things we want to make, we are going to need a cast of an ingot. Go ahead and set that in there and select our gold. We're going to need one gold ingot. So let that smelt up. Perfect. And we're going to take this and break it into nuggets. And then put that in there and surround it in string. That's four. And that'll make silky cloth. So make four of those. And then we take this emerald that I got from trading with a villager and we surround it in that. And that makes a silky jewel. So what this does is this is basically an auto smelter. And this is silk touch. So since we already have fortune on this, it turns out that auto-smelting will actually work, which is really cool. So I can set that in there and set in the lava crystal, and this will make it auto-smelt any ores we get, but the fortune will also apply. So we'll get roughly 2.5 bars, ingots, out of every ore. So that's pretty cool. So we have that, and I want to put silk touch on our shovel slash axe, because that's generally what you'd want that for. So we have silk touch. That's really cool. Now, basically, I'm just going to use the rest of this to put redstone on, and this will make it faster. So I'm going to do this for a while and see how much... This is going to be technically our last modifier, but as you can see, mining speed is going up 15. Oh, that's it. Okay. I think we can probably go up more. Let's take these out. I don't think I finished that. So put in a diamond and a gold block. Okay, so that gives us an extra modifier, so we can put on even more redstone. So the mining speed is 15.8, 16.6, 17.39, 18.2, 19. So you see it's just going up farther and farther. So now this should be a pretty fast pick. Let's see if it'll insta-mine this. Not quite, but it's pretty close. So this is a really good pick now. And if I wanted to, I could use one of these nether stars on it, which I might, we'll see. Actually, I want to use those on my weapons first, though. And we'll do the same thing with our shovel axe here. We'll just tack on a bunch of redstone to make it faster. Since we don't really want fortune, that's okay. Alright, we'll go ahead and add in diamond and gold block, which will give us another modifier. And add on even more redstone. Okay, so that'll finish us off. Okay. So now we have these really cool tools. They look really colorful and stuff. Like all green and red and blue. But yeah, this is really cool. And that's not the right stuff for it. But yeah, so we have a really good pick and a really good shovel and really good axe. All in those. Now, I'm going to use the nether stars on the longsword. I'm going to use one of them, because I want to put a lot more quartz on it, and hopefully this will be enough to get it to be a one-hit kill for a lot of mobs. If not, let's see, let's go ahead and make... I don't want to make all of those into quartz, but we'll just make maybe... that many. See how far that gets us? Because I don't think you can turn this back into regular quartz. Yeah, you can't. So I gotta be a little bit careful about that. So we'll just tack on some quartz to this. I might not even have enough quartz. Yeah, I'm not going to. Well, we'll just leave it like that for now. So I'm going to go back to the Nether and get some more quartz and get some more quartz for the Rapier. And I'll also end up putting some more modifiers on all of our tools. But basically, these are some pretty good tools. I think we've succeeded in our goal. What we wanted to do this episode was create the ultimate tool set. So we've got a really good mob killing weapon, a really good wither skeleton skull grabbing weapon. We have a really good player killing weapon. And we've got some other assorted, like the scythe and the battle axe, that we're probably not going to use as much, but they're still really cool. We also ended up with this really good fortune pick and this really good shovel that is also an axe and a hoe all at once. So I think that we've done fairly well for ourselves. I'm pretty happy. Yeah, we succeeded. So let me know what you guys think. If you think that these tools are pretty cool or not, if you know anything about the mod, any suggestions that you have, I can definitely try them out. Ah, that's so cool. Shovel axe, Mattock. So if we sit down, I think this will be pretty quick. Yeah, look at that. Pew pew! Alright. Cool stuff, guys. So anyways, I sincerely hope that you guys enjoyed this episode. I hope that you learned something a little bit about Tinker's Construct. I certainly did. This took quite a while, and this episode's probably pretty long, but that's okay. It's a special, because this is our first episode on the BKC Attack of the B-Team server, so I want to come in with a bang. I hope I did with these cool tools. So anyways, like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, then please hit the like button and consider subscribing, and I will see you guys in the next video. Hi-yah!